Welcome to the Micro Frontend Revolution with Eglowood IT Solutions, the podcast that takes you on a journey into the exciting world of micro frontend architecture. We'll explore how this groundbreaking approach is transforming the way we build and maintain web applications. In this episode, we'll delve deep into the concepts, best practices, and real-world examples that make micro frontend architecture a game changer. So, grab your headphones, get ready to explore the frontiers of web development, and join us on this thrilling voyage through the micro frontend revolution. Micro frontend architecture is becoming a popular architectural approach for enterprise-grade web development projects. With ever-expanding complexity and the need for building scalable web apps, the modularity of micro frontends development can help solve the shortcomings and challenges of the traditional monolithic frontend development approach. Hopping on to the upcoming topic, which is monolithic versus micro front-end architecture. Let's start by addressing what is meant by monolithic front-end architecture and micro front-end architecture. So, what is monolithic architecture? Well, monolithic front-end architecture is a design pattern with a single code base containing all the modules that are tightly bundled and coupled into a single application. This means that all business and application logic are bundled together as a single unit. When a monolithic approach is taken on enterprise-grade projects with complex architectures and layers of modules and features, it can often be challenging to maintain and update such a huge codebase while ensuring everything functions as intended. It also leads to delayed project completion time since the monolithic approach doesn't allow for independent development. Hence, if one part of the project is being worked upon, all dependent functions and features will be impacted. Moving on, what is MFE aka micro frontend architecture? In comparison, micro frontend is an alternative design approach to the traditional monolithic frontend. Here we split the enterprise app into various manageable frontend modules. Different micro frontend frameworks can work parallelly in a shared ecosystem. This decoupling of specific functions or feature enables different teams to take responsibility for one particular aspect of the overall monolith frontend. All teams will be responsible for building their micro frontend module individually and maintaining their code repositories. Hence, the micro front-end architecture helps break down the monolithic app structure, reducing the overall complexity and challenges of managing one large codebase and making the project more ready for migration to newer technologies. As now, we have better understanding of what monolithic architecture and micro front-end architecture is. Let's discuss the common pitfalls of the monolithic front-end approach. A monolithic front-end approach is only, in some cases, a wrong choice. There are many use cases and processes where sticking to a monolithic front-end approach might be more beneficial to some projects. However, there are some of the known pitfalls of monolithic front-end development that you should consider, and they are: Number 1. Complex and inconsistent codebase. When working on an enterprise-grade project, you need to hire multiple developers. Each developer has their method and process of coding. This makes it difficult to maintain a standard for consistency and uniformity throughout the app's codebase. Of course, such issues can be minimized if the entire dev team follows a common development pattern and industry-grade best coding practices. However, there is still a risk of encountering inconsistencies that may cause conflicts in the code, making it difficult to track errors, bugs, and other performance bottlenecks. Next one is delayed releases due to interdependencies of features. Adding new features to a complex monolithic project can be complicated and time-consuming. Since all features are packed in a single codebase, it can cause hurdles in the release of your new feature till the entire app is ready for release. Hence, if other developers are working on any other aspect of the app, your new feature will have to wait for them to complete their task to push your new feature to the production build. Number 3 is challenges with scalability. Scalability is one of the most important virtues of any enterprise-grade project. Since the monolithic architecture puts all the code in a single container-like space, scaling the app gets challenging and time-consuming as you need to deploy the entire app for the most basic changes to the codebase. Micro front-end architecture runs self-contained services where each service is managed, built, and maintained individually. Hence, scaling a particular component gets easier. Another one is project technology migration challenges. You must be more open and flexible to integrate new technologies in your monolithic app environment. All components are tightly coupled and interdependent. In such a situation, introducing a new tech stack or different programming language would require the developers to make necessary changes to ensure compatibility of your new framework with the rest of the codebase. Lastly, development bottlenecks and team conflicts. A monolithic approach requires you to deploy multiple development teams working on different aspects or features of the project. To ensure that the code doesn't break and each function performs its function as intended, teams need to coordinate with each other and be codependent constantly. This can cause performance bottlenecks, conflicts in the team, and delayed project completion time. Now, let's turn our attention to the next item on the agenda. How microfrontend architecture helps overcome the challenges of the monolith? As we have already explored, some of the major challenges with monolithic frontend architecture have to do with issues in implementing a smooth CI/CD pipeline, increased chances of code conflicts, challenges with scalability, and difficulty in code migration or adapting newer technologies. So how does the microfrontend approach help overcome these challenges? Let us dive right into it. Some of the benefits you can achieve by breaking down your monolithic app to a micro frontend architecture are: 1. Independent development environment. As discussed above, micro frontends address the issues of monolith frontend architecture by breaking down complex processes into more manageable self-sustaining modules. Each module represents a particular function or feature of the overall application and has a dedicated team working behind it, and they take responsibility for developing, testing, and deploying these modules independently. This reduces overall development time significantly and provides more flexibility for scaling and maintaining your application. 2. Improved scalability. Each module is loosely coupled, which means it is built, tested, and deployed individually without any impact from other modules. This helps work on particular modules that need improvement without it impacting the other modules of the overall enterprise app. Next one is technology flexibility. One of the most significant advantages of utilizing micro frontend architecture is the freedom of choosing a preferred framework, library, database for a particular module. It allows developers to optimize the app with the best tech stack available without worrying about migrating all legacy code bases to this particular tech stack. Number 4. Deployment flexibility. Micro frontends can be developed, tested individually, and deployed individually. Hence, if a particular function or feature of the app runs into any problem, the team responsible for that module can work on updating it, fixing the bugs, and other such activities without rendering the other functions and features ineffective. This reduces overall downtime and improves the system's reliability. 5. Better team dynamics. Since the micro frontend requires you to split features and functions into separate modules and assign a dedicated team behind them, you entrust these teams with complete ownership and responsibility for their functioning. This empowers the team, improves development efficiency, and increases productivity. Lastly, incremental migration, adoption. Switching your monolithic application to micro frontend architecture is easy. You can incrementally migrate your monolith codebase to micro frontend frameworks for a seamless risk-free transition. Onward to the next topic of conversation. Should you migrate your monolithic frontend to micro frontend frameworks? Though micro frontend architecture addresses many challenges and limitations of monolithic framework, there are better alternatives in some use cases. Deciding whether you should shift your existing monolithic app to microservices can be confusing. Let's explore few pointers that might help you make an informed decision. First, team size and organizational structure. One of the biggest questions of the microservice approach is having a vast team of dedicated talents with ample experience and skills to take ownership of individual modules. Hence, you should check if your organization has enough talent to be given such responsibility effectively. Second, migration complexity. Having an existing monolithic framework functioning to your requirements may indicate that you need not switch to a micro frontend. However, the micro frontend can truly benefit your project. In that case, you should assess the complexity, resources, time, and budget needed for refactoring, restructuring, and testing your existing codebase to ensure a seamless migration process. You should also evaluate the potential risk-to-reward ratio before making such a transition. Next one is tech stack evaluation. Check if your existing tech stack is compatible with the micro frontend approach. If you still need to, you may need to invest time and resources into learning new tech stack and migrating your project to newer frameworks and libraries. This is a considerable cost and time factor that you should consider. Last but not the least is scope of scalability and maintenance. Factor in your long-term and short-term business goals. Are you anticipating significant growth and increased traffic on your app, website in the coming years? If yes, then micro front-end architecture can be a better option since it allows independent module development, reduces the time for bug fixes and updates, and allows you to experiment with different tech stacks per your changing requirements. Moving along to the next point of discussion. How to implement micro front-end architecture? So, if you have decided to implement micro front-end architecture for your new or existing project but need clarification about how to proceed, don't worry, we have you covered. There are many flexible approaches to implementing micro front-end frameworks effectively and conveniently. Let's talk about some of the most popular micro front-end architecture implementation techniques, and they are. 1. Build time integration. Build time integration is one of the most common and effective micro front-end architecture approaches that allows developers to create independent and scalable modular apps. But, how it works? Well, each micro front-end is built and treated as a standalone application with its preferred tech stack. They have their development environment and can be developed, tested, and deployed independently. In the build process, all micro front-end modules are bundled together in a single deployment artifact through tools like Webpack or Parcel for compiling and packing the code of each micro front-end. This final product is deployed to a web server like Apache, Nginx, or any other preferred server to serve the app to the end users. The server will manage to route and serve the appropriate micro front-end based on the request path or URL. You can establish communication between micro front-end's frameworks using APIs or events. Each micro front-end can make HTTP requests to transmit or receive events for communicating with each other. 2. Runtime integration. Runtime integration is an alternate approach to setting up micro front-end architecture. It provides room for more flexibility in setting up a highly performant front for your enterprise apps. How it works, each micro front-end is developed and deployed individually as a standalone app. A client-side integration layer, like a JavaScript framework library, is used for loading and integrating all micro front-ends in a cohesive UI. Integration frameworks like SingleSpa, Qiangkun, and others can be used with React, Angular, Vue, or other popular front-end frameworks. The integration layer takes accountability for communication and routing between different micro front-end modules. It acts as a shell, container app that manages each micro front-end's lifecycle. Whenever the user visits the app, the integration layer dynamically loads the on-screen required micro front-end components based on the set routes. All micro front-end services load in their sandboxed environment to avoid conflicts. Communication between two micro front-ends can be established using global state management, shared event bus, or custom mechanisms. 3. Hybrid integration. Some applications have varying levels of coupling flexibility in different aspects of the app architecture. In such situations, going for hybrid integration to implement the micro front-end is an ideal choice. How it works, we combine the benefits and features of build time and runtime integration. Some micro front-end are implemented via a build time approach, while others are on runtime. The build time micro front-ends are bundled together in a single deployment environment using build tools, while the ones on runtime are integrated using client-side integration layers. Which module to shift using build time and runtime integration depends on factors like coupling level between different micro front-ends, development preferences, and performance considerations. Moving along to the next point of discussion. Challenges of implementing micro front-end architecture. Setting up micro front-end architecture has its own set of challenges and considerations. You should be aware of the possible trade-offs and impact on the overall performance of your project before making the switch. Let's discuss few challenges you might face while implementing micro front-end architecture, and they are. 1. Team organizing and responsibility assigning. Organizing teams as per your micro front-end requirements and assigning them a set list of roles and responsibilities can be challenging. Hence, you need a proper micro front-end roadmap and strategy to ensure no overlap, confusion in roles and responsibilities, or conflicts in the later stages. 2. Cross-cutting concerns. Implementing cross-cutting concerns like authentication, error handling, or other such activities can be challenging in a micro front-end environment. Such concerns require standardized approaches to ensure smooth performance across the app's architecture. 3. Testing and quality control. Yes, breaking down the monolith into smaller modular apps is beneficial as it reduces the overall complexity of your app's codebase. However, you need to individually test each micro front-end to ensure they function as intended and can be integrated with other modules when needed. 4. maintaining performance standards. Microfrontends can increase the overall performance overhead of your project since they rely on network requests and resource loading, which requires the team to pay closer attention to performance optimization and the successful implementation of strategies. Lastly, 5. Establishing communication and data sharing. Since microfrontends are designed to work in isolation, it can be difficult to communicate between two or more microfrontends of the same ecosystem. You must implement effective communication patterns to ensure seamless communication between different microfrontends. Pivoting to the next point of discussion. Microfrontend best practices to follow. As you can see, implementing microfrontend can be a challenging task. There are many considerations and challenges to consider when setting up your microfrontend-based applications. However, to ensure your project performs as expected and doesn't run into many issues, we'll explore some of the best practices to follow when setting up your modular frontend architecture, and they are: First, finding the right balance for microfrontend teams. One of the most difficult decisions that often lead to terrible outcomes if gone wrong is to figure out how to microsize your frontend properly. Suppose you break them into too many verticals. In that case, you'd need a bigger team to take responsibility for each module, and the complexity of the process would be higher than managing a monolith. If you under-microsize your monolith frontend, it will cause inconvenience with no measurable yield for all the efforts. Generally, the best practice for avoiding this is to ensure each micro frontend has a business purpose that is uniquely defined. Second, single-page application approach. It's a good practice to consider your microfrontend modules as single-page applications. Using popular frontend technology like Angular, React, and Vue, microfrontends can be created. This allows to combine the power of all and any leading frontend tech in your microfrontend modules without having to update it. Next one is effective communication handling. Though microfrontends are expected to be developed, designed, and tested in isolation, they do still need to be able to communicate with each other through a standard event bus. Hence, each module should operate independently in its tech stack and handle incoming and outgoing events. Fourth, workflow organization and alignment with business objectives. To successfully implement microfrontend architecture, you need to let different teams work independently on their verticals. Each vertical should have a set list of roles and responsibilities alongside a clearly defined objective statement that is agreed upon by the entire team at large. Fifth, use team prefixes where isolation isn't possible. You can avoid confusion and collision about code or module ownership by leveraging naming conventions for modules or processes where isolation isn't possible. You can use local storage events, namespace CSS, and other such methods. Lastly, different URLs for different SPA. Ensure your single-page applications or microfrontend modules live at different URLs. For any shared functionality, make use of NPM or browser components. Now let's discuss the real-world examples that make microfrontend architecture a game-changer. Adobe Campaign Microfrontend, transforming a huge monolith into microfrontend. Project name, Adobe Campaign. Project challenges, project started as a monolith frontend framework. But the app expanded in size, leading to a larger build, deploy size and time, and app testing efforts like unit, integration testing were also taking longer time. A high-powered Jenkins machine was needed to run and develop such apps. The codebase became complex to understand for any new entrants to the team. The proposed solution was to break down the monolithic Adobe app into smaller, manageable, standalone micro frontend modules. Moving forward, let's identify benefits of migrating Adobe Campaign to micro frontend modules, manageable isolated codebase. Faster and standalone deployment environments. Smaller impact areas that reduced the testing requirements of the whole application after deployment. Jenkins requires lesser resources and time. The team owns a codebase, feature in their respective module, enabling specialization by putting expert talents for their respective modules. Now, let's redirect our discussion to, how did they implement microfrontend architecture in Adobe Campaign? After careful planning and discussion, Adobe went with Webpack 5's Module Federation to set up their microfrontend architecture and React.js as their preferred frontend framework. Adobe Campaign started as a monolith, meaning all components were part of one big application block. They later migrated to MFE architecture by dividing the app into separate repositories. Let's delve into how they broke down their monolith front-end architecture for Adobe Campaign to manageable standalone micro front-end modules. 1. Application. The application is the main container that renders single-page applications and all their associated routes. They host and collate all micro front-end apps under this ecosystem. 2. Registry Config. Registry configuration holds the configuration of each build. All micro apps will use this registry to load their needed remote dependencies during runtime. 3. Common Libraries, responsible for holding components that can be shared between all micro front-end modules. 4. Micro front-end apps, standalone micro front-end modules that are part of the whole application. They can be developed and deployed individually. And that brings us to the end of another enlightening episode of The Micro Front-End Revolution. We hope you enjoyed our deep dive into the world of micro front-end architecture and gained valuable insights to apply in your own development endeavors. If you want to migrate your existing monolithic app to micro front-end architecture or develop a new enterprise-grade app with a micro front-end approach, consult our dedicated front-end consultants today and get started. If you have any questions, feedback, or suggestions for future episodes, we'd love to hear from you. Reach out to us on social media or email us. We're always eager to connect with our amazing listeners. EgloWord hopes you enjoyed and learned from this program. For more details, go to www.egloworditsolutions.com. Thanks for listening.